Hey, Jelly Toast here, back with more Somnium Files. Let's go. Yeah, manual save. Yeah. We're in Kuma Kuda's office. We're looking for balloons. It's so freaking hot here today.
Left half. Two X's?
Terror is just playing with us.
A challenge from Terror.
This was a result of genome experiments.
A police officer shooting at a civilian. It's unprecedented.
Dang, that was a lot of stuff. Aiba! What weather do you like? I like rainy or windy. Let's go for rainy. I want some rain. Melancholy! Man, I should really gun for all the different types of eyeballs I haven't gotten. Wink sync! What's up, dude? Okay, that was useless. Oh, he doesn't have a wink sync. What's with your voice?
This is a Vochlocho.
A what?
A voice-changing lock choker. It's a necklace thing that can change your voice. If I wear this, I can have the perfect voice.
The perfect voice?
For what?
So you actually want to sound like that?
No! You got it all wrong! This was a gift! It came preset like this!
Is this Iris's voice?
Who gave it to you?
Shinpei! He gave it to me yesterday. He said it was a thank you gift.
Oh my gosh, you're so weird.
I have analyzed the voice. The voice he is using now is that of Iris Sagon.
Yep.
Right. I knew I recognized it.
MoMA and Chimpei are hardcore ASET fans. Or perhaps I should say, Tessa fans.
So Chimpei gave him that Vochlocho with Iris's voice set as the default?
It seems that way.
What a creep.
I agree.
Yeah, it's like, no matter how much you like the voice, if you're saying all the words, like, that's kind of creepy. Vochlocho is a product sold on the dark web.
Ugh,
no!
Cold
use a PC to upload someone's voice to analyze their voice profile, input that information, put the Vochlocho on your neck. This allows for small electric signals to alter the voice. By the way, I'm good at voices too. Okay, so about Chikara's body being found.
I don't like it one bit. I don't get it, and I don't like it. The only thing I can tell you is that I have no idea.
Have you seen a balloon anywhere?
Haven't seen any.
There are supposed to be three balloons. You haven't heard about any of them being spotted?
Sorry, I got nothing.
Damn. We know Terror is abnormal. I figured since you're abnormal too, maybe you'd have an idea.
I'm not abnormal. I'm the most normal.
When he raises his voice like that,
it is not what I would call convincing.
Can you take it off?
The thing about that is, I lost the key.
Lies.
How?
Well, I was getting pretty into the booze here at the office last night with this thing on.
So you were playing around with it.
Gross.
The more details he gives, the creepier he sounds.
I woke up, and I couldn't find the fucking key! I thought I had put it somewhere safe or something, but I couldn't remember.
So that's why he called on my services as a lockpick to help.
I've known Leon for years. I know what he can do.
Thanks, but those are days I would rather forget.
I never will. Do you have any idea how much money you made me? I'm sure you know this already.
Oh, so did they already know each other from the first game? Time?
That's in the past. I've gone clean.
Anyway, Leon, get this thing off me. I got shit to do today.
Why don't we leave it on for a bit?
Ew?
Let me hear that cute voice a little longer.
Oh, you're such a creep.
Burn in hell!
Ew, no thank you. Leon, have you seen a balloon anywhere?
Oh, I saw one at Iowan earlier.
Yeah, I saw it too, but it's only red.
The orphanage?
Oh, no, wait. I was thinking about the shopping department. Iowan.
Yeah, it was tied to a tree. I mean, I didn't get a good look at it. It was just out of the corner of my eye.
Thanks, I'll go check it out. But why were you there?
I was there to see my beautiful princess.
About the balloons.
Balloons, huh? I wish I could float like a balloon.
About Chikara's left half being found.
That's a bizarre situation. I don't really know what happened, but I will say this. He got what was coming to him. You know that I was a janitor at Horidori Institute, right?
Yes.
Director Horidori and I talked. I heard a bunch of rumors.
Rumors?
It would take a while to explain, so I'd rather tell you later.
Hmm?
But...
Mizuki, I admit I am curious as well. However...
Right, we need to focus on the balloons.
Okay, let's go get the balloons. Bye, guys.
Hey, Liam! Please! Can you get this thing off me already? The Joker!
What's going on?
I hope this is playful fainting?
Moma is losing circulation to his brain. The Joker must be preventing blood flow.
Liam, please!
Wow, it's actually choking him.
Yeah, got it. Ugh, this old geezer. His breath stinks.
That's not the concern right now. This is life or death.
I can't help it. My sense of smell is better than a giant pouched rat.
Disgusting.
What the hell kind of animal is that? Couldn't you have just said dog?
Mizuki, look for the key.
The key?
The key that will unlock the choker.
I thought I had put it someplace.
Yeah. We just heard that. Key's not there on the chairman's desk. What is this? Okay, I saw a darker spot and I was like, weird. Dragon? Where is the key? Lantern? Key's not in the lantern. Crest? X-ray.
Is that a hidden safe?
Oh my gosh.
It appears to be.
There's an ASAP figure, and there it is! It's the key!
Yes, I am sure it is.
But why does he have an ASAP figure?
Why wouldn't he?
Mizuki, focus!
After all that...
You saved me! Sorry about all the ruckus. Thanks.
You should thank Leon. He's the one who opened the safe.
Haha, the master of unlocking at your
but
service.
I'm the one who saw it in the safe.
Nah, hold on. That don't make sense. Wouldn't picking open the choker be easier than picking the safe? Whatever.
Mizuki, we need to continue our investigation.
Right, we need to find the balloons.
Oh, I have an idea. Hey, Moma, can I borrow your Vochlocho?
Yeah, sure. You saved my life. I owe you one.
Thanks, Moma.
Give me the key also, so that I don't choke.
Now then.
Hey Beagle, how you doing? Thanks for joining! JB? Why B?
Let's go.
Go where? Well, let's go to Yokocho first. Because that was on our original list of places to go. Jelly Bingus? Jelly Bingus and Jelly Bongus! Zombies are running after you down the street. What do you ride on to try and get away faster? Unicycle, rollerblades, or piggyback ride the first person you see? Also, hi. Rollerblades. Because I can't get on a unicycle and I don't want to rely on another person to get me out. So rollerblades. I was like, hey Golden, how you doing? Thanks for joining. Happy Thursday.
Ooh. Mama at Marble may have information.
Yeah, I went into the office for the first time today for work because they got a desk set up for me. I am so tired. And I didn't even really work today. All I did was like really walk around the floor that I'm on to get used to where everything is. I'm so exhausted. Oof. I'd pick rollerblades too, even though I don't have that great balance.
Tell me.
Rollerblades are actually pretty easy. I think roller skates are harder to skate on, for me personally.
Chikara's left side was found at Yoyagi Park, right?
Wow, information gets to you fast.
I know when to make things quick, and when to take my time.
Ooh, mysterious. Wingsink.
I've got a riddle for you. If you get it right, drinks on me. What happens when you get rough with a fuzzy navel?
I don't know.
It spills, honey.
Huh? I don't get it. Whatever. I went rollerblading once in the 8th grade for a class field trip. I had to keep one hand on the wall at all times. Ah. Yeah, rollerblading, I guess, is a bit scary if you've never done it before. But it's fun. I feel like unicycle would be the easiest to get used to bouncing. But like, getting on it and then cycling around is hard. One of my old co-workers used to have a unicycle and I tried it out and I was like, I'm gonna fall and break my face. About the balloons. I told Mama about the challenge.
Hey, have you seen any red and blue balloons?
I haven't, but I can ask the Milky Balls. Oh, mighty balls. Who is the biggest liar in the world? Those bags that say tear here. Oh, absolutely right. What is with that?
Who cares about that?
That is totally unrelated.
But it's the truth.
Sorry, that was my heart screaming out to be heard.
I don't need to hear your heart screaming right now.
Now, let's try this for real.
Speaking of, the world's worst joke coming. Why couldn't a bicycle stand on its own? It was too tired.
The great and powerful.
I knew that one.
Find something for me. Where are the red and blue balloons?
You should go to Ikume Shrine, where the fruit of immortality resides. You will find it there.
Ooh, did that work?
Any information?
Yeah, I have a little nugget of information regarding Horidori.
You have dirt on Chikara?
The most pungent of dirt always makes its way to my nose.
So what information do you have?
Chikara was a devoted believer of a new religion called the Order of Percent.
What did he say, Jellybongas? You will go to the Dagobah system. There you will meet Master Yoda.
And their dirt is quite fragrant indeed. Anyway, he really believed in the simulation theory.
The Mark of Percent is a holy sign of the Creator.
The one
who
is the one who created this world.
They intentionally abandoned their memories so they could forge through this world of lies.
Which is why they worship the one with the soul, the persons.
Why would they purposefully erase their memories?
Part of their new scripture, I suppose. Smells fishy, if you ask me.
No fishier than you.
What's the sign of percent?
That I don't know, but I have a feeling it has to do with the case.
Oh, because I guess percents, like, it mirrors each other. There's a circle across the line,
you
so
know,
like...
The percent sign is two circles separated by a line. If you ask me how that's significant, I couldn't tell you. But this order of percent must be involved in all this somehow.
Well, I guess we should head to Ikume Shrine.
But we only got locations of two balloons.
Do you actually believed her?
Not necessarily.
Because when we went to,
Something, huh?
When we went to the mall.
Thanks, Mama. That was a big
It
help.
Was just a red balloon, and we found out
that
Ryuji went to jail.
But if it did, that's great. Come back again whenever. I'll be waiting.
I don't need to know about the crystal. Should I ask about? Let's ask about the crystal ball.
I thought I
told you about my great and powerful balls. After I plucked these out, I filled them with silicone.
Eh?
Oh, that's why there are two.
She is clearly joking.
Oh, okay. I won't delve further into that. 99 to red balloons. Something, something, German song. Play Night of the Consumer. I can't. Even from the title screen, I started getting super nauseous. So for like today's Game Grumps episode, I just had to turn it on and only listen to the audio. I couldn't watch it. It was...
You see? No balloons here.
Floating in the summer sky. Panic bells, that's red alert. Something here from somewhere else. Those are ominous lyrics.
Mama said...
You should go to Ikume Shrine, where the fruit of immortality resides.
I love that song. I should listen to the song.
I trust her mystical precognition as far as I can throw them.
I don't understand what this saying is. I only trust them as far as I can throw them. What exactly does that mean? So, the further you throw them, the further away you throw them, the more you trust them? Or the further away you throw them, the less you trust them? I don't understand. You get motion sickness? Oh yeah, I do.
Huh.
Because it's hard to throw somebody that far, meaning you don't trust them that much. Okay.
What's the fruit of immortality?
Thank you for explaining.
Anyway?
I don't understand some sayings sometimes.
Likely the Tokijiku no Kaku.
You know it?
Yes, I have heard of it before. It is said that eating it will grant
like,
you youth and eternal life.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do? And I'm just like, wait, I feel like that's too many double negatives. Like, what does that mean? Don't do anything I wouldn't do. So if I wouldn't jump into... If I wouldn't jump off a bridge... So they're saying, don't do that. Right? I don't know. My mind. It's so confusing.
Many believe
my
it
brain
is a Tachibana
hurts.
Orange. It is an object of worship at this shrine.
Wow. The fruit of immortality.
So maybe it's inside the shrine. Duh.
Hey, wait! There it is! The balloon!
And since I brought it up,
you're correct.
I'll check out that
this
link
is a
later.
Red and blue balloon.
See, I told you.
How did Mama know?
Doesn't matter to me.
Her balls knew.
It should.
Let's try popping it. It looks like there's something in there, like the one at Yoyagi Park. Let's do it.
Yeah! Three?
What does it say on the back?
Indig.
Three and Indig. We cannot currently decode this message.
You don't say.
We need to find all three balloons.
Can I leave? Yes. Ion. It's almost the weekend. Whoa, actual children.
What is it, Mizuki?
Nothing, just... this really takes me back. But now's not the time for reminiscing. We need to find the balloons.
Takes me back to what? You were probably too young to- these children are red! Like, she was too young to remember her time here, because she was adopted by her parents. No balloons in this area. Where's the balloon? No balloons in the building. No balloons around the playset. No balloons anywhere? Sandbox! Sandbox! Freaking... oh wait, the tree? Ah! Why are you surprised at the tree? Castle slide? Don't see any balloons. Jungle gym? No balloons tied here. Donde esta? Oh, it's all the way up there! Look, that's what they said, ah. There.
No doubt about it. That is one of Terra's balloons.
Just like Lian said.
But it is high out of reach.
It's fine. I got it.
She's got superhuman abilities.
Hi-ya!
Get the card. Shouldn't they all fall at the same time? Because isn't that the theory that even if you drop a feather and a rock at the same time, they'll both land at the same time? Even though you think the rock will fall faster because it's heavier?
Don't sweat the details.
Well, in any case, you did reveal what was inside the balloon.
Yeah.
It says two.
And on the back?
Unra?
No way. Terror is... a pervert.
Huh?
What?
Unra? Clearly it's a...
Oh wait, whoa. Why is this happening? I pressed nothing and it just went by itself. Unra, it's clearly it's a code for undergarments. Terror is a panty thief. What?
The one at the shrine said three.
And on the back it said indig.
It is still indecipherable to me.
There's one more balloon left.
But where? We don't have any more locations. Afterward, I asked the workers and the children if anyone saw someone tying the balloon to the tree. But it was no good. No one saw anything. With that settled, Aiba and I left. Oh, the nurse!
Hello. It's a nurse.
It's the nurse. What food do you like? This time I'll say sweet, because last time I think I said salty. That's loving. Okay, I'm a child. Let me check. I'm the loving one now. So this one is Hitomi. So I have to aim for not loving answers either. Impish or crazy. Or brave, I guess. We'll see. Just not love. Hi there. Wink, Zink.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo. Wherefore art thou, Romeo? Because that's what Mom and Dad named me.
She appears to be in a theater group or something.
Yikes.
That's interesting. About who tied up the balloon. Wait, let's greet her first.
Good day. Are you here about Chikara? I saw on the news that a corpse was found. That makes the whole thing even more baffling.
What do you mean?
I had always thought Jin Furaway's disease had something to do with his murder. He had half-body tumors.
Half-body tumors?
It's a rare disease that causes tumors to develop only on one half of the body. Organs, skin, bones. I don't remember which side of the body it was for him, but I always thought his murder had to do with the disease somehow.
This is new information.
But Chikara doesn't fit into that at all.
I remember. Chikara's right side that was found at Sekiba High had all the innards removed.
That wasn't reported by the press.
If the innards are all removed, how does a skeleton still stay? Because whenever we x-ray it, the skeleton is still there, intact, but... Huh?
Whatever the case, the nurse may have just given us a vital clue.
put it in her notebook because it's Blue's Clues about who tied up the balloon.
I didn't see anyone. I just got here moments ago.
I see.
If no one saw them, they must have snuck in at night. The security here is pretty bad. It hasn't improved any over the years. But that is how Mr. Chieda wants it. This isn't a prison. We don't need cameras. Oh, if only we did. That awful incident all those years ago could have been avoided.
Awful incident?
What incident?
The missing child. I'm sure you've heard of a child going missing from Ion.
Mm-hmm.
Uru Somazuki, a 6-year-old, went missing one day. Whether it was kidnapping or an accident, no one has any clue. And he still has not been
found. There's what light through yonder window breaks? 'Tis the east, and I hated that book. Yeah, I was like, why is this known as the greatest romance of all time when they were just children? They had no idea what they were doing. Romeo was a little horny turd. Juliet was just a young, naive girl. Everyone was crazy. Meh. How long is this game? I honestly have no idea. I have not looked up any information about this game. Innards removed. That'd be a great subtitle for a horror movie. Ooh, yes it would.
It was a distressing event.
If they had cameras, maybe it could have been prevented. Even after that tragedy, Mr. Chieda still refuses to upgrade the security around here. I don't know what he's thinking.
Maybe he purposely wanted a child missing for experiments.
There is much to think about. We need to find all the balloons.
Yeah, you're right. Let's go.
Go where? Time to go back to Hollow Knight. Ha 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 ha. Good joke. Whoa, turbo blasters. Boosters. Blah. After that, I went to different places around the city. But the last balloon was nowhere to be found.
Ugh. The sun is already setting. What do we do?
Calm down, Mizuki. It is dangerous to drive while agitated.
It's fine. At this speed, falling wouldn't even hurt me.
But the bike could break. It was provided to you by Abyss. If you damage company property like that, it will come out of your salary.
Ugh.
But she's super rich.
Good girl.
Incoming call.
Mizuki, it's from Boss.
Crap.
I will connect you.
Hey Mizuki, I got a call from HQ. There was a report of someone spotting a balloon in the warehouse district in Ariake. Can you head there right away?
Wait, but...
I was there already.
I didn't see any balloons.
You must have missed it. They said they saw it around 8:30 a.m.
8:30 a.m.
Anyway, I'm counting on you.
I don't remember what time I went.
If the balloon was there at 8:30 a.m.
And it was gone by the time we got there.
That must mean...
someone took it.
But who would have done that?
Could it be?
Again? Was he like, oh, pretty balloon, and took it? Funny thing, my sister is a Shakespeare nut, so I knew the Romeo and Juliet story before we read it in 9th grade. What I didn't know was that they were like 12 or 13 years old and Juliet pretended to die near the end. She didn't pretend, she was just like, okay, so this'll knock me out. And I could be with Romeo. It's just Romeo was a stupid idiot and hastily decided to off himself.
Again.
You can download a co-op mod so I can help you. It's okay, I'll leave Hollow Knight alone.
Hey, you can't just barge into the kitchen like that.
Just listen, please. Gen, are you hiding something from me?
Oh, did you find out I've been using frog meat?
Cut the shit. I'm searching your place.
Stop, hey, come on. My customers are going to be freaked out if they see you rummaging around here. You can't be touching things in the kitchen, it's unsanitary. And on top of that, boy, I hate to have to ask this, but do you have a warrant?
Mizuki.
I know. There's a way to search without touching anything.
Right.
X-ray. X-ray. Wait, Why do I not have the option for x-ray? Do I have to talk to him first? You know about the balloon, don't you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
There was a report of someone seeing the balloon at around 8:30 a.m. at the warehouse.
Make me dab. Ew, oh, my shoulder hurts. Oh, I need a massage.
You said you were there around 8 a.m., Gen. You must have seen it.
What do you want?
What do you mean? I don't want anything.
Can you stop for a second?
Sorry, I can't do that. I've dedicated my life to cooking, unlike Oda Matsushita.
Why do you hate him so much?
Because he's a scrub.
How would you feel if there was an excellent sharp knife just sitting there, rusting away because no one was caring for it? It's like that.
It's Gen, he's cooking. Where's my option for x-ray? Freezer door. Trash can, x-ray.
There it is.
A popped balloon. But x-ray will not reveal the color. It could be a coincidence.
Hey, what are you-
Shut up.
Oh no, this 12-year-old girl I met the other day and had a one-night stand with while her parents were downstairs talking with her arranged husband looks like
what
she's dead
this?
And I haven't done anything to check to see if she really is. I must drink this random cup of juice I found, which may or may not be poisonous. No, he stabbed himself, didn't he? And then Juliet's like, oh no, he died. And so she stabs herself with the same knife. And then they both really die. Need us to put you in some jujitsu holds to help your shoulder out. I just need a massage.
Why did you lie? Actually, I don't really care why right now. I need you to answer me.
Where did you put the card?
There should have been a piece of paper in the balloon. Where is it? Are you really not gonna tell me? Then you're coming with me. Or I can have the cops bust in here and close you down for the day to search every inch of this place. Which do you prefer?
Am I gonna have to dive into your brain? DDP yoga? What's that? I'm pretty sure Romeo drank the poison, or maybe he drinks it then stabs himself because it didn't kill him. Either way, dumb kids. No, because the poison was only supposed to put you in temporary sleep. So that's what Juliet drank, and then Romeo's like, oh no, she's dead, so like, he stabs himself. Because he's dumb.
Why
and melodramatic.
That's what I'm gonna sink into him to find out.
Well, you may not discover exactly why during the sink.
Oh wait, we've never sinked into Gen before.
But I can still get valuable information.
Ah, you mean what the piece of paper in the balloon said.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know why it's taken me so long to get over this jet lag. It's been almost
Mizuki,
a week and I still wake
you start,
up at 5:30.
I'll say one thing.
I know. I can only stay in Somnium for 6 minutes. I've heard it so many times I can hear it in my sleep.
Well, technically...
Let's just get started.
Okay.
Technically, you are
Ready?
Sleeping.
And let's begin.
Shall we play a game? You have set us up the bomb. Doom, 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 doom. Ooh, we're in Brahmin. There's water outside.
This is Brahmin.
This is a small place. Finding what we need should go quick.
I would not be so sure. You can never anticipate what might happen in Somnia.
Anyway, what is that you're doing there?
Salmon. I am imitating the rugged salmon of the Sea of Okhotsk.
But why?
We are here to investigate Gen. He has been acting fishy lately.
Ba-dum-tsh.
Ha ha, very clever.
Shall we begin?
So we're just not gonna acknowledge that, huh?
Somnium scan, activate!
Let's go! How many mental locks? Two. Whoa, Amame! Amame? Four, okay. Find the clue again.
Guess we should look around the place first.
Okay.
Menu. Elephant. Door. Let's check out the menu. Table seat. Inspect.
A normal table seat. It's a little tight. Maintaining social distancing would be hard.
Golden Yokocho has tons of tiny restaurants.
Okay, useless. Ganesha. Inspect.
This is a picture of Ganesha,
a Hindu god.
She was beheaded, and her head was replaced by an elephant.
Stories about gods are always really out there.
This picture is blank.
What do you mean blank? There's a picture of Ganesha there. The pot? Wait, the pot's not. Gen's cooking notes. Duh, because that was the first lock. Let's use a half and read it.
Let's see. By incorporating different flavors, a patron will be able to enjoy this same cuisine multiple times. The angle of the knife can change the flavor, texture, appearance. For intestine stew.
Wow, Genny. He sure studies cooking hard.
Geisha? No, Ganesha.
You can tell how serious he is about being a chef.
Which explains why it tastes so good.
Okay. That was simple. Win the cooking battle. Cooking skill blank can be improved by blank blank.
What is this?
Komeiji's voice. TV? Or maybe the radio?
Let's look.
Why is his voice so muted out?
Something's happening over there.
Blackout!
Aiba, you okay? What happened?
What? The floor!
What happened? Sounds like he's yelling in an empty gym. Yeah. It sounds so far away, too. Any day, guys. Any day now.
Now returning back to us, our mysterious Super Chef A!
Whoa!
The pride of our culinary academy, Super Chef A!
What?
Why are we in the soccer stadium?
Super Chef A? Aiba?
This episode's battle shall be A versus Gen. Our panel of gourmet dining expert judges tonight shall be...
Why are those people gigantic?
Matsushita Diner's very own, Ota Matsushita, to provide commentary.
Why?
I'm looking forward to tasting Super Chef A's dishes. But the other contestant tonight has a chance to finally impress me.
Before we've even gotten started, Ota is already trying to get under Gen's skin. He is known for his brutal honesty.
And his stupidity.
Our second judge for this evening shall be... the beautiful Amame Doi from the fine maid cafe establishment, Sunfish Pocket.
Good luck, Genny!
Hey now, you're the judge. You can't play favorites.
Play favorites.
It's fine.
Oh no, wait, I forgot fair. He's going up against me. Play fair.
Let's get a comment from both of the contestants. First, Gen Ishiyagane.
I don't take cooking lightly.
Oh, you can sense his passion burning like spicy Korean cuisine.
Korean!
Next is Super Chef A. Tell us what's going through your mind right now. Okay, we're almost ready to begin this showdown.
But why in the soccer stadium? Has he been here before? Did he drop off Jin's body?
Again?
If you win, can you unlock his mental lock?
Even if that was the case, I've never cooked before.
You're a high-tech artificial intelligence. You can do this.
I hate cooking.
I can?
Yes, if you train.
Train?
We can use the timey from earlier to shorten any amount of time down to 1 second.
Well,
oh no, true. I used a half though.
Even a few hours of practice will not be enough.
Rack, waste.
I said any amount of time.
Mizuki, don't tell me. What are you thinking?
Thinking about training.
Are you serious? Please, tell me you are joking.
Oh my gosh, maybe I don't have to train. No, let's train. It only takes a second.
Seriously?
Kinda looks like the kid is a Pokemon gym trainer. Oh my gosh, it does! And so, the long days of training began. We're in the hyperbolic time chamber. Korean cuisine, BBQ, and cover everything in spices. Just remember what FF15, Tales of Symphonia, KH3, and Persona 5 Strikers taught us.
You call yourself an AI and that's all you can do? Do it again!
Yes, chef. Sorry, chef.
No. If it's anything I hate in games, it's fishing and cooking. I guess sometimes cooking isn't bad. It's just unlocking all the recipes. Ugh. And so the months passed, nearly a year later. Though only 1 second had passed in reality.
You dare challenge me to a battle of culinary prowess? Pathetic.
Yes. I've created a monster! A cooking monster!
Bring it on, Gen Ishiagane.
Wow! Look at that passion!
So what you're saying is Overcooked is your favorite game? Overcooked is less about cooking and more about cooperation and planning.
This battle's theme is a multi-course meal.
I do enjoy it, but I need to play that game with like an actual controller and not just the Joy-Cons, because those controllers are not good for like precision directions.
Chef's battle!
I've learned to appreciate fishing minigames from a video.
Tonight is the night we reveal the fruits of our cooking.
I still can't appreciate it.
What will you make first?
A salad. Fiber is an important part of a healthy diet. With my
I'm glad I finished getting all the fishing trophies in near replicants.
I can do anything.
And now all that's left is farming for materials to upgrade all my weapons.
Let's cook.
Oh, input cooking command. Sorry, I had to concentrate.
Witness my superior cooking technique.
True story, I've never maxed out the Fox's social link in P4G because you have to get really good at the fishing. I'm nowhere near good enough to do that. Oh yeah, first time around, I totally did not max it out. But then, like, after that, I was just like, fine, let's do it. I recommend a game to you, JT. Play it up. It's a roguelike cooking game. What's a rogue cooking game? I can tolerate fishing in Zelda, but I'm still not good at it. Yeah,
what
I just...
is she doing?
Hate fishing.
She must be making some kind of salad.
Wow! She threw the ingredients into the air! And she jumped after them!
Good thing this stadium is so enormous.
The vegetables are getting sliced up. I can't even explain what I'm seeing.
I get it. By slicing the vegetables high in the air, she's
what is this? Shokugeki no Shoma?
Texture and flavor.
Incredible! The Super Samurai Chef A is closing her eyes now.
She sees the food with her heart.
Samurai's sympathy.
What? She didn't cut anything.
No, look.
A spiny lobster. The passion, the pride.
What?
It's a symbol of her dedication to win this battle.
What a crazy dish.
Aiba, what was that?
Cooking is an invitation to taste and see with your mouth.
Roguelite, but for cooking? I don't know what that means, Regal. Samurai pizza cats.
Spiny lobsters are yummy.
I see. It sure looks impressive.
Huh?
Eyeball!
Spiny lobster salad. Done.
Looks good.
Chef A, what a natural. Her first dish is complete.
Looks like a solid dish.
What's happening on the challenger side?
Bibimbap?
That's a bit heavy for an appetizer.
Yeah, that's like a legit meal.
This is bibimbap salad. I want a mommy to feel comfortable expressing herself, to show the range of her emotions.
Which is why you chose such a colorful salad.
My salad's colorful too.
And the egg on top is an accent? As much as I hate to admit it, it's clear plenty of thought went into this.
What's next on the menu for Gen Ishiagami?
Egg on top is normal?
The main course.
It's looking pretty good. We can't lose, Aiba.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Also,
I did not endure
that
training.
Okay, if it's just bibimbap salad with none of the rice underneath, then it's just all the vegetables, so you're just eating... Okay, whatever.
What are you making next?
My main course. Meat. I will bare my soul with this dish.
Input cooking command. Yes, got it.
Witness my superior cooking technique.
Now, Super Chef A, bury her soul.
Looks like steak.
A steak? Kind of a simple meat dish for her maid, no?
Miss Super Chef A, I'm sure she has some plans for that meat.
I see. Let's take a look. Wow. The meat is up in the air.
She's instantly resting the meat after cooking it. It's a high-level technique.
And now Super Chef A has taken flight.
Gen's
like
just gonna make
hawk.
Everything that's a comfort food
to
Amaman. He's gonna
salt
win.
The meat in the air.
Wow. She's salting while spinning.
Amazing.
Why is she doing this?
I don't know. It's beyond comprehension.
Now Super Salty Chef A has returned to the ground before the meat. Wow, she's blowing onto the gas stove and creating a pillar of fire.
What? Hellish medium rare.
At a high temperature. She's going to trap in the juices.
Steak cooked over the fire of Hades. I'm really.
What's the other stuff? Chicken thighs?
I can't wait to try it.
What are the chicken wings around
chicken
the steak
wing?
For?
It imitates the beautiful legs of an insect.
Ew.
Aiba, are you trying to lose?
The aesthetics of food is just as important as flavor.
Okay, if you really think so, you
it's
do
it's like
you.
Hades or Binding of Isaac or Rogue Legacy or Enter the Gungeon or Risk of Rain or Spelunky, random generated stuff. Ah, oh, I see.
That's... My elegant steak meal is complete.
It looks good.
Our fantastical
do I only get the eyeballs
Super
if I do a perfect
a
command
course.
Input?
Huh. Meanwhile, on the Gen side,
is that fish?
Amame deserves to be free. I want her to be herself.
Yes, free as a fish, swimming in the vastness of the ocean blue.
Steak versus fish. This could be what breaks this stalemate.
Gen's doing fish. Are we gonna be okay?
Worry not, my little kitten. Did you not see how much training I accomplished?
I feel like this persona of yours is getting weirder and weirder every time I talk to you.
The time limit is almost upon us. The next dish will be the last.
I'm making dessert, of course.
The finishing touch will be dessert. Mine will be the best.
Okay, here we go. Ooh. I almost messed up.
Witness my superior cooking technique.
Super Chef A finale. What will she make? It's a dessert. The Super Chef Miracle Whip.
I want chocolate cake.
She's whipping like no one I've ever seen before.
Whipping is all about the speed.
Wow, what's this? She's going so fast, it's creating a pillar of light. She's throwing strawberries into the light.
The sky is sucking up the strawberries.
Wow, what is happening?
What is happening?
Chef A, queen of all, has been absorbed into the pillar of light.
The queen will now challenge the gods themselves.
What is going on here?
Huh? Surviving hostage challenge against the gods.
Super Chef A of the sky has returned from the heavens.
Have the gods forgiven her hubris?
The god Chef A is holding a cake. What? You can't even see the top.
Is this a Tower of Babel of a crepe?
By challenging the gods, she created a cake Tower of Babel.
It is Babel.
The most insane dessert mankind has ever seen.
Even the gods are amazed by this dessert.
I think you're taking this way too far.
Is this...
more eyeballs!
God cake? Served! How do you even eat this?
Now, Ultimate Chef A has completed all her dishes.
Can that dessert be defeated?
Let's check out Gen's side.
Donuts?
Amame deserves love. Forever and always.
The idea here must be that everyone, young and old, male and female, loves donuts.
Everyone loves cake, too.
I remember back in the day, people would line up for hours to get good donuts.
And cake.
This looks promising. Both contestants have finished. Now is the time for judgment.
I will judge which three-course meal is the best for me.
Oh, yeah, that was the theme. Iba, are we okay?
Instantly gets Catherine Babel PTSD. Oh no, I've been wanting to play Catherine.
It should be fine.
I need to finish getting platinum for that.
I hope so.
Which means I need to get gold trophies for every stage, and I need to beat all of Rapunzel, and I need to get all the endings, and I need to beat Babel. Oof, I still have so much left to do in that game. To quote the great philosopher Homer Simpson, donuts.
Judgment time! Please judge the shocking superstar Super Chef A's dishes first.
This is good! This lobster is a work of art!
My clothes are tearing off because it's so good!
This is good! It almost tastes like it's alive!
What do you mean by that?
It's so good, I can't tell if I'm eating or if I'm being eaten! My senses have inverted from the flavor!
That didn't clear it up.
It's nice and juicy!
I want that cake.
This is good! This cake is going to take me to heaven!
She literally did that!
The sweetness is just right!
And the challenger, Gen's cooking.
Bibimbap salad? I hate to admit it, but this is pretty good.
Yeah, it's good.
The fish is perfect. You can taste the freedom in the flavor.
The fish is so good too!
And this donut, you can taste the spirit of it. It's a flavor unlike any other.
What?
Yeah, it's good!
Wow, the lexicon on her! A simple, it's good is all she had to say.
Because it's good.
In any case, who will be decided the winner?
I'm on the best this commentator. It's good!
Do you think you're gonna win?
I hate to say this after all that, but is this even going to uncover Gen's secret?
Let's head to the results.
Yeah, see, this is what I'm saying. Like,
please.
All the people Somniums I've gone into... like Amame's, Kizuna's, someone else. It's just like, oh, okay, we're finding about your sob stories.
Super Chef A!
Oh, I won.
What?
Yes, we did it!
Why? It's like...
Why?
Nothing really to do with any crime scene investigations. It's more just, let's delve into their memories and personality to find out more about them. And then at the very last moment, okay, now here's something about the case. Like,
huh?
It's Gen weird.
The cage.
He locked himself up after being rejected by a mame.
So you shouldn't have won?
No, the mental lock is unlocked. We are certainly closer to his true heart.
Hmm.
Gen put all of his passion for a mame into his meals.
But she doesn't care about him.
Let's investigate the dishes.
Cooking skill can be improved by repeatedly performing the same action command. Hmm? What Uma do you like? La Chupacabra! I like it because it's a goat monster. Supposedly. No, wait. It eats goats. Never mind. No!
You have 4 minutes remaining.
I like goats. They're cute. Let's investigate. Oh. Maybe I should do the bibimbap first.
Bibimbap salad.
Ota said the egg was important.
Inspect.
Bibimbap salad. It is an intricate dish.
No, it's not.
It could even work as a meal.
It is a meal.
The key to this dish is the egg.
I wonder how it tastes.
Okay, I was supposed to eat it.
Ota said that...
Let's just use a half. Eat it.
Yes, let me taste it.
Kill him? No! We do not kill him. We find out what's wrong with him.
I am sure you're well aware, Game, but you are the result of genetic modification. You were birthed from an egg that had its genome altered in the course of researching eternal life. But this resulted in extreme changes in your bone structure. Your epidermis is also abnormally hard, closer to rock than human skin. You are a failed experiment. Pitiful, really.
You're the one who did this to him, you douche. Find out what's wrong with him, and then kill him. I like his name, Chitara. But he's Chikara, with a K. But I get what you're saying. Chitara.
I was born into this cruel world looking like this. But I don't resent Chikara. Not really. Maybe it's more accurate to say that I've lost all emotion. Happiness, joy. It's all gone gray. This is just my reality. It's how I live every single day.
I want a mommy to feel comfortable expressing herself, to show the range of her emotions.
That's terrible.
Chikara Horidori is an awful man.
Yeah. He was psycho. Don't think I'll find any eyeballs, so let's just move on. To the main.
This is Gen's fish course.
Let us... Should I inspect it for the half? Should I just eat? Yeah, cuz... I'll just eat it.
I will try it.
Yum.
Hey! What are you looking at?
Nothing.
What's with that mask? Why don't you show us your face?
Why don't you mind your own business?
Monster! What the hell is with this guy? He's a total freak!
I didn't do anything.
Fuck!
Fuck off!
You're the one who bothered him first!
When I was younger, there was this kid bullying me. I pushed him and ended up breaking his bones.
Good.
It's like everyone says, I am a monster.
No, he's a jerk.
If I stand up for myself, people get hurt. So I just took everything I got. All the judgment, the teasing, the beatings.
I don't If something someone...
Amame deserves to be free.
Looks like...
I want her to be herself.
Or wears, bothers you, just go away. You don't have to look at them. You don't have to interact with them. Like...
3 minutes left.
And if you're just like, well, they shouldn't do that, blah, 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 blah. Just walk away. No harm done. Like,
Gen's donuts.
Eats.
Let's try them out.
Please don't tease me. I wouldn't tease. Let's just like... Yeah, the older I get, the more I realize, like, looks doesn't matter. I mean, personal hygiene does, like, make sure you don't smell and, like, clean yourself up, like, take showers, brush your teeth.
What am I gonna do with all this stuff?
But, like, eh.
You seem like you could use a hand. Can I help?
Like, if I saw someone like this walking down the street, I wouldn't be like, yo, show me your face. And then, like, beat him up if I didn't like how he looked like. Like, why would you take the time out of your day to do that? It's stupid.
Oh, thank you. Yes, could you hold my baby for just 1 second? Oh, you're hideous! What are you? Don't touch my baby!
People avoided me.
So she bought so much stuff that
I was useless in a society.
She put it in her baby stroller that she couldn't handle her baby.
It was like I didn't exist.
Stupid lady.
Or maybe I'm not allowed to exist, which is why I started living my life in hiding. Amame deserves love forever and always.
Everyone deserves love.
Gen was ostracized by society.
Except
lives a lonely
sociopaths.
Life. Genny.
And mass murderers. Okay, so do I talk to Gen now? Or Amame? Release Gen from the cage. No! Amame was the mental lock.
Amame, do you know what was missing from Genny's dishes? What? It appears there was a specific reason Gen lost.
Gen's self-love, motivation, creativity, feelings for Amame. I'ma say... I will say creativity, but Gen's self-love is 30 seconds, so I'm gonna go for that.
Self-love? Yes. I appreciate the way you care about me, but... You can't keep hiding your heart in a cage, Genny. I want you to escape that cage.
That's how you know she's a first-time mother? But even if you're a first-time mother, it's just like... You came to the mall like with a baby and a stroller. You knew how cumbersome that was. And you know how much you shouldn't be buying so that you can go back home relatively easily. And she didn't.
I think the same way.
So what you're saying is you won't be taking future baby Jelly to the mall with you?
unless I have help going with me, myself. No.
People get hurt.
Like, I know
so I just took everything
you should take
I
your child to different places so judgment, that they can experience different environments meetings. And, like, see new things.
It's like everyone
take
says,
in new information.
I am a monster.
But it's just so cumbersome
I never
that I'm just like, nah, I won't
monster,
do it.
Genny.
Aren't you afraid?
Not at all.
Aren't I disgusting?
No. I think you're charming, if anything. And I know that your heart is more pure than anyone else. I want you to love yourself more. Do it for me.
But I...
That's why I love you, Gen. That warm heart of yours, too. The way you look. All of it.
Amame.
Show me your face! Depending on whether it's a boy or girl, their name will be Jilly Bingus or Jelly Bongus.
Oh, I know. Amame never feared me. I do have a place. There are people out there who need me. Not many, but it's enough. My place is here.
I wanted to eat your cooking, Genny.
I remember now. I remember her saying it before.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Frog meat again?
Nope. This is alligator.
It's really good.
Thank you.
Release Gen from the cage. Satan face calling it. I wanna see! Find the last clue. We put it in our note because it's
Who's
clues.
I'm really
clues,
happy.
Clues.
Now let's go back. You idiot. We haven't found any clues yet.
Here you go.
What?
One clue for you.
Oh, thank you. Hmm? It looks like normal omelet rice.
It looks like a balloon. Eat it. Oh, 320 seconds? Oh, if only I didn't use that half on that stupid. Oh,
okay. Let's eat.
I would have made it with 1 second left. Mother flipping!
Alligator meat is surprisingly easy to eat. Huh? What happened? That's.
Toast.
The paper! That means Gen did have it. Yes! Now we can go back!
Miss.
Everyone says gator meat tastes like chicken. I'll stick to actual chicken. Same.
I won't lose next time.
Apologies, but you can face Ota next time. I do not want to go through more training.
I wasted the half. I am a fool. Performance result, Fajra. Left Behind, Musiki Chapter 2, Still My Birthday.
Where's Genny?
Abnormal activity was detected in his brain after the sink.
Uh-oh.
It's not anything serious, but Pewter decided to take him to the medical office as a precaution.
Gen's brain is atypical. The nano cables may not have been connected properly.
Uh-oh.
Is he okay?
Like I said, nothing serious. It's not life-threatening, and there shouldn't be any side effects.
I'm sleepy.
Okay,
I'm
if
heading
you
off.
Say so.
Yeah, I'm gonna head off soon, too. I'm so tired. But have a good night, Regal. Thanks for joining. Have a good weekend.
But I wanted to ask Annie tons of things. About Chikara and why he lied.
I am curious about that, too. But we should hold off until later.
Yeah, before we do anything, let's solve Terror's annoying little puzzle.
Night.
Right. We got our third clue in the song.
Yeah, I'll just figure out the clue and then...
The pieces of paper in the balloons. One said one, and on the other side, host.
The one at Ioan said two, and Unra. And?
The one at Ikume Shrine said three and Indig, right?
Ding.
Yeah.
What are these signifying?
Well, if we line up the letters... Indigo Underwear Hostess?
That's way too many letters. Where are you getting this from?
Oh, I know!
I know you don't know, so don't say anything. You were probably about to say something even worse. Could you two please take this seriously?
What was she gonna say?
The letters on the pieces of paper, what do they signify?
Let us solve this clue. Oh, Golden, those are such cute emotes! Okay. Host, Unra, and Indig. One, two, three. What? Host, Unra, Indig. What could this be? Ooh, rainbow cockatoo! Cluster running. One, two, three. Or he on the strut. And this thing has 12 spaces. So we have to use all the... What if I take... No, that's not it. I feel like the last four letters should be ding. Ray. This is why I was never good at crossword puzzles. But this isn't really. Wait a minute. Log. Because it's like two letters, two. Wait. It was split up by two letters, not four letters. So. If we do. H. H. O. S. T. UNRAINDG. So if, and if we, I don't know if we used the arrow thing from Alfrey before, but if we do that, then it's ho da in Horror Institute Underground. In Toots Underground.
Horadori Institute Underground.
I did it.
Precisely. Under Horadori Institute of Genetics.
Easy peasy. Whoop, whoop, whoop. I didn't even have to look up a guide. Sync is only a means to gather information for an investigation. Nothing learned in Somnium can be used as evidence. So Aiba and I headed to the Horadori Institute of Genetics.
No warrant? We're not letting you in without a warrant.
And as expected, we got shooed away. But then I gave the security guard a hard right hook and crushed his jaw, and then... Nah, I didn't. I just thought about what boss told me.
If you cause me one more headache, I'm cutting your pay.
I put my metal pipe away. Looks like we've got to do things the hard, peaceful way. I looked around the building for any way to get in. And about halfway around the building...
A back door.
But it was locked, and it looked like there was an alarm on the door. Oops, I got sticky stuff on my screen. No! That's when... Sticky stuff on my screen, phrasing.
Well, well.
Why?
Well.
Oh, the receipt I was using got wet, so I stuck it on the screen because that's what I was writing the clues on. And when I took it off, like, it left remnants of sticky stuff.
Thank you for your help.
Oh, Leon.
Nah, don't thank me. I'm just doing this for old time's sake.
I was wondering, though, where is this underground room?
Oh, right. Terror's challenge.
Never mind, dirty joke. I'm so... Yep, I'm dumb. Ignore me.
It pointed you to underneath Horadori.
I'm still just so happy I got this riddle.
But I've never seen anything there.
Huh.
I mean, I heard people talking about it. I heard this one lab guy there say, hey, this lab that we're in, this is a huge space. There might be some hidden passageway or something.
Oh, excuse me.
But it's not like they knew for sure or anything.
A hidden passageway.
You're gonna look for it, right? I'll help. I already bought this ticket. Might as well take the ride.
No, I do Aiba and then I save and I sleep. What should I do if I saw a UFO? Wave, hide, get on, hide thumb. Wave. Okay. I'm going to save. Save current game. Yes. Cool. Data has been saved. And I'm gonna end this- Oh, bless you. Thank you. I'm gonna end the stream here because I'm getting so tired. I'm still not over this jet lag and I need to pass out soon. So. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Stay toasty, have a good weekend, and hopefully next week I'll be able to stream on Monday. I feel like Monday, Tuesday, and possibly Wednesdays are my best days of streaming. Definitely Monday, Tuesday. I'll try to get a Monday, Tuesday schedule up and running again. Is it cool if we raid Slushy? Sure. Let's raid her. Raiding Slushy. She's playing Final Fantasy XIV. Okay. Anyways, see y'all next time. Bye-bye.